Today is Sunday, it's the 29th of May 2022, and we've ventured to the southeast, I guess, part of Mallorca. We're in Felanitx. It's about almost an hour's drive, a bit less than an hour, depending on the traffic from Palma. So it is quite a way to go, but it's one of the places that have a market on a Sunday. It's a bit noisy, so we're going to have a little look around the market. We've started with a coffee. We had a long drive, so starting with a coffee today, not finishing with a coffee. We'll probably finish with one as well. So let's have a look around the market when we finish the coffee. This is actually a new market for us. I don't think we've ever been for a walk around Felanitx before. There we have Nduno people who live here. So we've got the usual leather bag stores. We've just been looking at satchels. Anita and I both remembered that we had satchels to take to school all those years ago. So I was looking them up on Google and I found one, and it was $369.
I had a
brown one that I used to strap on my back and take to school. I think that was when I was in primary school. I think when I got to high school, I used to take a briefcase. The kids now all take rucksacks. Oh, lots of hats. You spoke to me about having a hat. I quite like the hat I've got, actually. I say I quite like the hat I have already. It's the end of May and it's very, very warm. So the temperature's close to 30 degrees. So it's quite warm to walk around a market. Some street entertainment as well, opposite the cafeteria. Just going to put the camera up a little bit for you. You can see above the heads. Well, we were talking about hats. I think that's about the third hat store we've seen. I quite like my own hat. Anita's gone in search of a lottery ticket. Very interesting looking church in front. And on the left I've got the materials. What sort of different materials?
You got a winning ticket there? You got a lottery ticket?
Oh, she hasn't got one yet. In search of.
But I think the budget is on Tanto puedas.
A ver si la mal tiene.
Quite busy for a Sunday morning. Like I've lost Anita. Well, I think we'll probably be going back that way. More leather up there. We'll go down this way, shall we?
I don't think we'll go back down that way.
We've got to go back that way because that's where the car is. Steps that take you down to the font, the shrine there, but not a lot of water in it at the moment. Anita's found the flower stall. Felanitx is actually quite a big town. I mean, we think of the main towns as being Palma, Inca, Manacor, Llucmajor, but Felanitx is not far behind them. And the church is actually open. Well, I said it's Sunday, so I would hope it is open. Might try and have a look around there a bit later on. I use that. Onthe is the a charity for principally for the blind, and they make a lot of money by selling lottery tickets, and I think Anita contributes rather a lot of money to these lotteries. So, actually in the shade now, so it's a bit cooler. Must be a winning ticket. I was impressed by these throws, incredibly cheap, €8 for a handkerchief for €8. Ah! Just caught her eye on something else, so I'm just going to slowly make my way up here, actually walking along the side of the church now. No idea how big this market is, but it's already looking quite big just from where we've walked already. That's the 5 to 12 bell. I think my watch is wrong, let me just check that. Yeah, it's 5 to 12, so they're probably calling people to a 12 o'clock mass, so we won't get into the church. Parking was a bit of an issue when we came in. We looked in the streets and not really found, so we actually started driving out and just found a piece of spare ground where we could park the car. And just looking above there, there is a municipal indoor market as well. Might be able to get into that in a moment or two. We've still got a bit of market to walk around yet. You can see how busy it's getting now. And noisy. And another lottery sale. Right, she's bought the winning ticket, so no need to buy any more. Money transfer system. Very lively town. Staying on the east coast of Majorca, Porto Cristo, Colonia Sant Jordi, then this is actually isn't too far from you. Staying in Palma Nova and Magaluf, Santa Ponza, it's a long way from you. Thank you. parasol up there.
Some pies down there.
Okay. And we were wondering what to do for lunch. We might buy a pastry of some sort. To markets, then this is one you should pencil into your itinerary, but you will need transport. There's no train to Felanitx that I know of, so if you want to come here, it's bus. There will be a bus from Palma, but it's on a Sunday, so I'm not sure how regular the service will be. So it's really, if you've hired a car, then this is somewhere you could actually come to. But you'll find lots of things here. And if you look down the street, you find lots of cafes and bars open, so you can always stop off for a drink or a bite to eat. I always worry when I hear music, because that sometimes stops my videos being published. So I may have to cut some bits out. Sounds like live music. We've had a lot in the past of these spit roast chickens, really incredibly tasty. And just look at the queue here to get the spit roast chicken to take home for their Sunday lunch. I'll try and get through. I'm going across anyway. Here's some live music on stage. We have a four-piece band.
Good.
They're pretty good.
Gracias.
This is what I was looking at. Here we have some pastry type things here. This is the sweet side. I'm hoping on the other side they might have some not so sweet. This is actually, so it's a native Ukraine. I'd be very happy to buy something here. I think we should get some.
Anava a fer una i després m'esturarem 10 minuts per descansar i després continuarem.
I'm just going to buy something there to help the people from the Ukraine. The band are still playing. And hopefully this won't get cut out. So we're going to head back. We've got now our little pastries, and see if we can get into that church. If they've not got a mass on, I think those bells were signaling people come to a mass. Would that be right, darling? Is that what they did? Chicken smell good, and there's still a long queue. People trying to get them.
nice, yeah? I'll come back again.
Across the road, we've got a traditional barber's shop. And they're open on a Sunday morning, and somebody's having their traditionally cut. It's quite smart, actually. Past the leather goods store, and you know it's a leather goods store because you can actually smell the leather. Well, I am very impressed by Felanitx Market. Are you impressed by the Felanitx Market? It's a really nice market, nicely laid out. Busy, but perhaps not too busy. It is a Sunday morning, very hot. I guess people are heading out to the beach today if they've got a family. Be interesting to try it at a different time of the year. If you've watched Anita's garden, she's got lots of bugs. She's just telling me she wants this one. You think our garden's big enough for that bug? That's a crazy size bug. I want to take a closer look. No dear, you're not having that bug. I'm going to head down this way. I did see as with all markets, if you're watching this video on our Just Ordinary Steve and Anita YouTube channel, then you might want to switch over to the 360, because markets always look better. As Tommy tells me, they look much better in 360. You can pause, you can look around, you can look at the things that I'm not looking at, and you can see what's going on in front and behind. They're quite amazing. So if you've not tried the 360s, do have a go. Try and get your resolution right up to the full 4K. You can zoom out and zoom in. You zoom in, it doesn't look so good. You zoom out, you can see a lot more. So it's really the way forward for watching things like markets. You can have a good look around, which is what markets are all about, having a good look around, spying that bargain. Two pieces for 12 euros. Wow, that's like the hippie market in Magaluf we went to the other day, but a quarter of the price. Two items. Anita did buy a t-shirt at the hippie market, that was 10 euros, I didn't think that was too bad. As someone has sold t-shirts in the past, 10 euros sounds a good price for a t-shirt with a specific print on that you want. Yeah. But the big sizes, right up to 5 and 6 XL. Don't tell Anita, they come for me. This is the Church of Felanitx. Look at the stone. It's this marais, which is a type of sandstone. And I'm just looking up, and typical of sandstone, it's suffered from weathering. I'm just doing that with some of my Year 7 students at the moment, talking about weathering, and that's done with wind and rain pretty much. That's taken off a lot of the brickwork up there. A lot of that sandstone's got eroded. The only way really to procure it is to take the block out and put a new block in. It's a specialised job, obviously. Church. I'm just going to go up to the steps, but the bells were ringing a few minutes ago, so I'm not sure whether they were signalling a mass or not. We can have a closer look at the entrance. In the rose window up there, with the angel guarding the entrance, and the year on there is 1762. Fortunately, there's a mass, and I'm not really happy to wander around while there's a mass going on. But maybe that's on a to-do list. We need somewhere we need to go to. Right, we're going to head back to the car now. Well, pleasantly surprised by the wonderful market here on Sunday in Felanitx. And we're going to head back to the car now. So thank you very much for watching, and we look forward to seeing you in the next video. Bye for now.
Bye.
Bye. So I look as though we're going to get a couple of little postscripts to this video, because Anita's spotted this house, well, a couple of houses actually, which have got some interesting stonework, but also the beautiful bougainvillea growing up the side. And then I noticed just over here, one with a nice plaque showing the cross being carried. And just another little postscript. We've just come down from the church, and just hidden away is this statue of a water carrier. Nicely done statue there. We're actually just above that Fuente Pública that we were looking at. That water actually looks a lot cleaner. Leave Felanitx, just wanted to do a little video. That place in front, the building in front, it looks a grand sort of building. It's called the Syndicat de Felanitx, and it has been in the news quite a bit over the years that there is an intention to do something with that building. I'm not sure what, but it looks like quite a grand building that has just unfortunately been left derelict. So hopefully the council, there's a sign in front which is can see, says Consell de Mallorca, so that's the Council of Mallorca, have obviously got some interest. And then there's another poster next to it which says about works to recuperate it, to rejuvenate this this site, set just below some little mountains there, little hills. So a really beautiful spot. It could be something fantastic for the local community.